energy, and through these groups of Neva substance, the heads of the three departments remain. It is one of their 678 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. Channels for work. Master Jesus is particularly active at this time along this line, working in collaboration with certain adepts on a scientific line, who through the desired union of science and religion seek to shatter the materialism of the West on the one hand and on the other the sentimental erosion of the many devotees of all faith. This is made possible now through the passing out of your sixth grade and the coming in of the seventh. It should be borne in mind by all students when considering the plane substance and energy that they are in a condition of flux and change all the time. The matter of all planes circulates, and cyclically certain portions become more energized than others. The matter of the planes is thus under a threefold influence, or to word it otherwise, evil substance is subjected to a threefold cyclic stimulation. 1, 2, 3. Ray stimulation dependent upon any ray being in or out of power. It is intersystemic and planetary. Zodiacal stimulation, which is an extra-systemic stimulation, and is also cosmic and cyclic. Solar stimulation, or the impact of direct solar force of energy upon the substance of a plane, disseminates on the heart of the sun, and is peculiarly abundant. All the planes are subjected to this threefold influence, but in the case of the Buddhas and the astral planes, the force of this third stimulation is very great. The adepts working in conjunction with the great devil symbolize this opportunity to effect definitely constructive results. 8. A group of devas closely connected with the mysteries of initiation. They form what is esoterically called the path of the heart, and are the bridge between the astral and the Buddha plane. They are in no way THOUGHTHTANDEFIRELEMENTALS 679. Connected with the permanent atom in the causal body, but are very definitely associated with the central tier of petals in the egoic lotus, hermit of petals of love. And source interacts between these three petals on the one hand, and the devas who form the path of the heart, upon the other, those who are the bridge of astral Buddhic matter. Whereby initiates of a certain mystic type make the great approach. 9. Devas of all degrees and vibratory capacity will make up the bulk of the desired forms of every kind. 10. The devas of transmutative force. They are a peculiar group of devas who embody life desires of transmutation and are called by various names, such as the furnaces of purification, a melting element, the dots of incense. It is impossible to enumerate more now, and likewise profitless, and it has only been deemed advisable to bring these many types of diva substance to the notice of students on account of the preeminent importance of the astral body and the three worlds. It is by the domination of these diva lives, and the transmutation of desire into aspiration, and by the purificatory fires of the astral plane that man eventually succeeds in attaining Buddhic consciousness. It has been the recognition of the cleansing power of the approach of water and blood that has led to the emphasis laid by Christians, even though erroneously interpreted, upon these two. 3. THESOLARANTELS, the Admitratus. Introductory remarks. Rest are here upon connection with our planetary evolution. It is the one having the most occult significance for man. For these solar angels 19 concern his own essential nature, and are also a creative power by which he works. For all practical purposes, and for the elucidation of the spiritual evolution of man, this immediate section is of the greatest interest and importance. It should be one of the most widely studied sections of this treatise. Man is ever profoundly interested in himself, and before he can fully develop must comprehend scientifically the laws of his own nature, and the constitution of his own mode of expression. He must realize likewise somewhat of the interrelation of the three fires in order that he may himself at some future date place forth. Fire Dhyanis and their relation to man is the most profound mystery, and the entire matter is so clear and intricate legend that students are apt to despair of ever arriving at the desired and necessary clarity of thought. Not yet will it be possible entirely to dispel the clouds which veil the central mystery, perhaps by tabulation and synthesis, and by a cautious amplification of the data already imparted, and thought to the wise student may become somewhat less confused. There are two statements in the secret doctrine which are often overlooked by the casual reader, but which, if 19 solar angels are therefore entities of a highly spiritual order with a refined consciousness that corresponds to the material substance in which they are clothed. In order to connect this with what I have said already, you may consider the solar angels as collectively forming the Lord Rama or the file. The angels are called by various names of planetary spirits, Asuras, etc. In order to get a proper idea of their nature, you may consider them as standing in the same relation to the spiritually regenerated and released world Brahmins or the Germanakai as would be standing in the ordinary humanity. The angels were clever Brahmins in previous for the sake of rearing wisdom in the world, and hence they emerge as angels from the infinite mystery deity under their karmic image after a period of Mahapralaya. Some thoughts on the and the vitality of the physical frame is to be gained largely by the permission and action of the heart. The heart circulates vitality.